Hey, I'm Ella,
and for my personal project, I'm doing how to learn how to perform an Ollie on a skateboard, and then make an educational video teaching others how to perform the trick themselves, skateboarding. My AOI is Approaches to Learning, and I will take lessons until I am able to perform an Ollie on a skateboard. I will then film a video that teaches the viewers to perform the trick themselves. I need to research how to teach the trick in a way that the audience is able to grasp through film, and I will also have to research the art of taking a video, especially of skateboarding, as it is fast movement. I will have to learn film tricks such as slow motion editing and voice overlay to create my video. Thank you. So
okay, so we'll start with like the pieces of the board. So first we have the tail, which is the back of your board. And you can tell because it's a bit shorter than the nose, which is the front of your board. And I know because of my truck bolts, because my instructor painted them blue, so I knew what's the front, but it doesn't really matter. So the truck bolts hold up your trucks, and they're also a really good way to know where to put your feet. And the trucks hold the wheels. These are the wheels, I customized mine, and the trucks are basically how you turn and how the wheels are attached. And yeah, that's the board. I choose this design, and it's Adidas cliche, so you can choose any graphic for your board, and then also you can add stickers to customize it the way you want. So this is sort of what I'm into. It's like music, so I added that. And then on the top, this is called the grip tape, and it's how you have friction when you're on the board, or else you just slide off. And if you ever need to customize your own board or build one, you have to put the grip tape on like a square and then sand down the edges. So before we get started, we should probably talk about falling. My coach says that 80% of skateboarding is falling, and 80% of the time that you're on your skateboard, you won't be on your skateboard. You'll probably be on the ground or in the air. So like I said before, for foot placement, you use where the truck bolts are. So when you're just going forwards, you need to push. So first, you put your leading foot on your truck bolts, and the other foot's on the ground for the push. And your foot is facing forward. But when you do push and get on your board, both of your feet need to not be facing forwards anymore. They need to be facing sideways, right? Then when you want to push again, you need to turn this so it does face forward and take this foot to push again. So for turning while you're on your board, you turn when you're like this. And to turn, you either put weight on your heels or on the front of your feet, which puts, you can hear it in the trucks, it puts pressure on your trucks and it makes you turn a certain way. Like that. So for stopping, what you want to do is while you're here, you want to turn back to vertical and put your other foot on the ground to stop the board. Another thing you can do if you're really afraid of what's happening on your board, you're not comfortable, you can either always bend your knees, because while you're on your board, your knees always need to be bent. So if you're uncomfortable, you can bend them even more, so that if you do fall, then you're closer to the ground and it hurts less. But one other thing you can do to stop if you're uncomfortable is just simply jump off the board. And the one issue with this is that your board will go shooting out. And if you're in a skate park, you do need to say board so that no one else gets hurt. So the technique to ollieing is actually, it's pretty simple. It's only four steps. So the first step is that you need to have your, well, okay, first for foot placement, your foot needs to be in the middle of the board, in between your two truck bolts, and your other foot needs to be right on the edge of the tail. So not fully over the tail, just right on the edge. So the first step to ollieing, step number one, is that the foot that's on the tail is gonna pop down. And it's sort of like just a flick, just like you would flick your wrist. So that pops down, which makes the board go up like this. Then the second foot that's in the middle has to turn and slide, kind of like sliding a matchstick, over the top of the grip tape. And this will flatten the board out like this. And that's the second step. And the third step will be that you need to get your foot that's over here and your foot that's over here back to where the truck bolts are. So that for the fourth step, when you land, you have both of your feet on the truck bolts and your knees are bent so that you don't fall off. So that's an Ollie.
So if you're gonna start out with Ollies, you should probably not start out on hard ground, because if you try on a carpet or on grass, then there's a lot less chance of you falling or the board flying out, and you don't want that when you're first starting out because it makes you not want to try it again. I would know from experience. So when you're first starting out ollieing, you might not want to just go straight to ollieing. You might want to try some other things before so that you can do it better. So some things that my coach has taught me. One is you need to practice the flick, because it's not just go down on your toe like that. It's just a little flick on the end. For practicing that, you can practice flipping your board up and holding it like that. And that's a good one. And then another thing to practice is starting like this, and then this is how you practice landing on both of your bolts, like that. And when you do land, you need to have your feet, your knees bent, obviously, because then you're close to the ground, and if you do fall off, you won't get as hurt. So like I said, the positioning is one foot in the middle, and then one foot just on the edge of your tail. Even though there's only four steps to ollieing, it's mostly timing, and you have to do the popping and the sliding at the same time. If you want to start with a stationary ollie, so as you get more comfortable with the ollie, you can start trying on flat ground, but you always need to be careful and you always need to think about safety and protecting your head and anything else if you do fall. If I didn't reach my goal, I know that this video maybe will help people learn and maybe show girls that they can skateboard even better than guys. And if you're ever down about skateboarding, or you feel like you can't do it, you just gotta keep trying, you just gotta practice every day and never let anything like a fall get you down, you just gotta keep trying. I'm waking up on Hi, I'm Ella, and for my personal project, I'm doing okay. Good, please don't be in my videos.
Who? The dog?
Okay, we're good.
Yeah, we're moving filming.
Like my coach says, about 80% of skateboarding, I'm losing my foot. Okay.
just like do a bunch of tricks.
You and Ollie.